don't do you. I find the things that you do will make me feel all right. Ow! So I understood I'm home, 'cause when I get you alone, you know I feel okay. When I'm home,
what do we do with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor? Am I in the morning? What do we do with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor? Am I in the morning? Am I in the morning?
It'll soon be here. It'll be better than before. Yesterday's gone. Yesterday's gone.
Hi, Mel.
Hey, Mel.
Hey. Hi, everybody.
Hello.
Hey.
Hey, everybody.
Hi. Hey, everybody.
Hey.
Oh, yeah, it's me.
You know what, like to keep my cheese.
called a recovery. Hello, everybody. How you doing?
Hey, everyone. Everyone. Including Greg Turlock, Gordon and Vivian Bryce, Mandy Eddy, Kelly L, and Elizabeth Ostrosser. If anybody else is here, please say hello. We are called Sarah and Adam. We play for you live every Tuesday night from 8 o'clock until 9 o'clock. That was a song by Blind Melon, and I wish I had a little girl running around in the tutu, but I didn't. So,
there. Yes.
The next song we're going to do is by the Cranberries, and it is called
Dreams.
Where's my capo? There it is. I did just say that. Three.
Two.
Oh, that's why it was tough the other night. Okay. I really got to write these things down.
Hello, Grant Church. Hello, Brian Reddy.
Hello, Grant Church and Brian Reddy.
Are you ready?
I'm ready. Thanks for saying hi, everyone.
Yes, hello. It's great to see everybody. Happy Tuesday, as we say. We're called Sarah and Adam. We're here every Tuesday to play songs for you at 8 o'clock for an hour or so. And so settle on in. And oh, my mic's really high. This, look how high my mic is.
It's very high. It's very high. Mine's like way down here.
Yeah. But yeah, we do this every weekend, and we have a great bunch of people that come and join us and chat and stuff. If you're sitting in the background thinking, I don't know if I want to jump, yeah, come on, just say hi.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, say hello.
Come on. Be great.
Or you can voice your opinion by smashing that like button right in its face, whether
smash
you're on
it.
Facebook Live
it's
or on
like
the YouTube.
It's like punching me in the face. So if you feel like punching me in the face, hit the like button.
Don't do that. Or if you want to punch me in the midsection, you can do that with the subscribe button right there.
Tickle the bell.
I don't recall ever seeing the bell, but apparently it's out there. It notifies you if somebody's
there's a bell, Adam.
Doing a thing.
It's not on the subscribe thing, I don't think, but there's a bell.
Hi, Debbie. So now we're going to do a tune by the Traveling Wilburys.
The as traveling opposed to Wilburys. The ones who are static.
Yes, as opposed to the stationary Wilburys. Yes. Hope you enjoyed all that reverb. During all that talking, that was a gift just for you.
Oh my god, the reverb was on.
Oh no!
Stop it.
It's still on right now.
Deb thinks we're sounding good.
Oh, that's good.
She likes the reverb.
Well, good.
Yeah.
Stick around, Deb. We got some cool announcements coming up for stuff that's going to be happening this week and beyond. Okay, we can play now. Oh, you know what?
What?
I have my page turner.
Oh my god.
Yeah,
what
you
are
know
you
going
to do?
I'm going to get you to tell everybody about a cool thing that's coming up for you, for the shop.
Oh, yeah.
Coming up soon.
Guess what happened today? I had my store open, and actually it happened this morning before my store was open. For those of you who don't know, I have an antique store. Are you going to hit the button or what?
Yeah.
Okay.
There.
I'm doing my first antique market show thingy in Toronto. Yeah, baby. May 5th. From 9 until 4, I will be in, actually, Mississauga at the Small Munitions Arms Factory or something. I haven't quite figured out where that is yet. But anyway, it's a market that's held one Sunday a month, I believe. And I'm doing it. I'm going to be there. I'm going to be a vendor at this antique show. So that's really cool because it's my first thing. And I'll go back to the camera because there we go. The graphics ended, but...
Just before you do that, hang on a second.
What?
Who's that? I just wanted to show you guys something else, too. This is cool. Okay, so first of all, this is the website for Sarah's shop, sarahchurchshop.ca. So go there if you want to check out some of the stuff that she's talking about, that she's going to be bringing to the show. And then I wanted to tell you a little bit of a story. We went and Sarah was very kind enough to take me on a tour of... a place called Cottonwood Mansion that's right around here. I don't know if you guys have heard of a Cottonwood Mansion, but it's really, really cool. It's this old house from the 1800s. And this isn't from Cottonwood Mansion. This is an item that's in Sarah's store. It's a fire screen. And the tour guide told us what the fire screen was for. Apparently back in the day, the ladies' makeup was made out of beeswax. And so these screens would protect their faces from
melting off
while they were... you know, socializing by the fire after dinner. Not their faces melting off, but, you know, their makeup, you know, streaking down their face, which I think would look hilarious. But that's awesome.
That's a great tidbit of information there.
We always wondered, like, they're called fire screens, which is cool.
I know what they're for.
But they were, like, really high, you know what I mean? Like, they were...
They're adjustable.
You know what I'm saying? But it's weird because I would think, you know, if they were screening you from the fireplace, they'd be at fireplace height, but they're not.
They're adjustable.
Yeah.
They only put them up when they're on display.
Anyway, it's
really
cool.
But the one I have is not adjustable. In fact, the one I have is quite unique. It is enormous and possibly made of mahogany, so really heavy. But it has definitely got a unique piece of needlepoint in it, which is a parrot. With beady little eyes.
Yeah, so that was cool. It was neat to learn stuff, and that was an awesome tour, so thanks, Sarah, for that. I learned all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
It's great.
When I was a kid, my parents had a farm around there, just off of that road that Cottonwood Mansion is on, on the 5th concession. And we used to drive by Cottonwood Mansion all the time. But I'm pretty sure it was vacant then.
Yeah.
Now it's a museum.
Yeah.
And a venue for things like weddings and car shows and all kinds of things.
Yeah. It was an awesome tour.
Yeah, it was a great tour. Our tour guide, Casey, was awesome.
Yeah.
She was full. She was a wealth of information.
Yeah, she was.
I asked her a million questions because I wanted to know things.
Yeah. Well, we were lucky enough to be the only people on the tour that day.
That was awesome.
And instead of being awkward, it was amazing. It was great. We got to like poke around and look at stuff and like it really get in there. It was awesome.
There was a shadow box of hair, of women's hair, like a wreath of hair.
Yeah.
It was like all little flowers made out of hair. I got a picture of it.
It was really big, you know, like, I don't know if you've ever seen hair jewelry before, but usually it's for like a funeral or something.
No. They call them mourning brooches and stuff. They would have a piece of the deceased hair, like a lock of their hair inside a brooch.
Oh, I thought they actually made a thing.
No, okay. They were just inside a...
Anyway, this thing was massive and it was really ornate and beautiful. It was gorgeous. It was a really cool piece.
Yeah, it was awesome. It was great. But if you get the chance or if you feel so inclined, Cottonwood Mansion is a great piece of Ontario history.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Highly, highly recommend. It was
awesome. Yeah.
So here comes some traveling Wilburys for you.
That's right. After that dissertation.
The reverb is back. The music is on. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Someone to tell you everything at the end of the line of the line. Sit around and wonder what tomorrow may bring. Maybe a diamond ring. Well, it's all right, even if they say you're wrong. Well, it's all right, but sometimes you gotta be strong. Well, it's all right, as long as you got somewhere to lay. Well, it's all right. Maybe somewhere down the road a ways at the end of the line. You think of me and wonder where I am these days at the end of the line of the line. Maybe somewhere down the road when somebody plays purple haze. Well, it's all right, even when push comes to shove. Well, it's all right. Ashamed of the car I drive at the end of the line. I'm just glad to be here, happy to be alive at the end of the line of the line. It don't matter if you're by my side, I'm satisfied. But it's all right, even if you're old and gray. Well, it's all right, you still got something to say. Well, it's Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So that was song number three, lady.
Yeah. Sure was.
Yes. What does that mean?
Well, why didn't you ask sooner? After song number three, we pick up a beverage of choice.
I was singing a song.
Open it. And cheers.
Yes.
Before we take a drink. That's what we do. Broken down. Very plain. Very simple.
Yeah. But well dissected, though. I like it.
Do you like that?
I do.
Okay, let's do it.
It's good. All right. What are you partaking in this evening?
Ah, the one that's hard to open. Oh.
Nice.
All right, cheers, everyone. Thanks so much for coming out.
Yeah, cheers. Hope you got a bevy. It's yummy. Last night, Sarah did some research just for you guys to find out about health. She took it on herself to find out what was more healthy, a glass of wine or a brownie. Unfortunately, it was the glass of wine. But the good news is, it's a glass of wine, so that's good. There's an upside to that, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's good times. Do you have mixed feelings about that?
Yes, because it's not like I'm drinking the best quality wine. So, like, a brownie of any kind is good.
Yes.
All the time.
That's true.
But a glass of wine that's very light in flavor can get old very quick.
Yeah. Quite.
Anyway, I'm just kidding. I don't know.
Oh.
I don't know. Nothing seems to get rid of inflammation. Just nothing.
Right.
Nothing. It's just there forever now. Just forevermore. My eye will be red and my elbow will hurt. Forever. For the rest of my life. Cheers to that.
Okay.
Good. Cheers. I had a cheers. There you go.
An impassioned toast. Tobacco and wine. Good choice. It's a good one. Very nice beverage.
What do we got next, Adam?
Now we've got a little Fleetwood Mac selection for the folks at home.
Great. This I love cool. Fleetwood Mac.
Yeah, me too.
I love this song.
Yeah, Fleetwood Mac is great. He's awesome.
I love this song.
Okay, you ready?
Yes.
Here we go.
Loving you isn't the right thing to do. How can I ever change things that I feel? If I could, baby, I'd give you my world. How can I when it won't take it from me? You can go your wrong way. Turned around, packing up, shacking up, so you wanna do. If I could, baby, I'd give you my world. Open up, everything's waiting for you. You can go your own way. Thank you.
Yeah, actually, I haven't tried this yet, which is an exciting adventure because it's an old school remedy. Super old school. I wish it was in a super old school, like brown bottle or something.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
But it's not. It's by Life. It's a Life brand. Plastic bottle of castor oil.
Yeah.
Apparently, it's good for many things, but what I'm going to use it for is pain. And apparently you rub it on the area or the opposite area that it hurts. So like if your back hurts, you put it on your belly. Like if it's your lower back, you put it on your belly and apparently it works through you somehow to relieve your back pain. I don't know. I haven't tried it yet because I also have that, but I'm going to try it on my elbow. Mm-hmm. Try and make it better on the opposite side. So I'll just put it like on the inside and then it'll... Yeah, castor oil. If anybody else has tried castor oil that way before, let me know. Let me know how it works before I do it.
So it's kind of like wood finish. The pharmacist said, try a little bit on a little area that nobody's going to notice. He did. That's what he
said.
Yeah,
I know, but that's not only wood finish. They say that for a lot of things. It says it's cathartic. So
it's going to have an epiphany while it's working, I think, which is cool. That's pretty cool.
Cathartic. I'm going to have an experience. Catharsis.
Speaking of a catharsis.
Hey, that kind of makes sense.
It does.
Oh my God. Speaking of catharsis.
Yeah.
What's this segue?
How about a Beatles song?
How does that have to do? What? Yeah, we'll do a Beatles song, but I don't get it.
You will. By the end of it, you will. You'll have an experience and you'll be like, oh, I get it. I understand now, man.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Okay. I know what happens when you drink castor oil.
That's right.
It's not pretty.
No. Effective. Not pretty, though. No. Hello, Mel. Good to see you. I'm glad that you're here. That's awesome. I got your voice message this afternoon. I'm going to give you a shout right after the show, if that's okay, if it's not too late. So, just so you know, I did get it. Yeah, so that was the Beatles, of course.
And sure was.
A tune by Alanis Morissette now.
Yeah, that's right.
Hey, just before we do that.
Yeah.
I still got the thing on. Yeah. How was your gig at Barrafion? Barrafion. How'd that go?
It was rocking.
Yeah.
It was a good night. It was a really busy place on Saturday. Yeah. Barrafion is a place in Burlington on Guelph Line, so kind of north. Mm-hmm. In a plaza with a Food Basics and stuff in it, and a McDonald's and whatever.
Stuff like that.
But it's a very delicious smelling restaurant.
Yes.
And it's torture, pure torture playing there as all the food comes out of the kitchen and goes right past me.
It's so,
it looks so good. I have tasted some of the food there, but usually when I'm there, I get a salad because it's easier to play and sing after you eat a salad than it is to eat a big, big, delicious
roll on
meal.
Stage and be like, falling asleep.
Well, I don't think you would with their food anyway because it's a lot of like Mediterranean stuff.
Ooh, nice.
But still, I don't want to push it, you know.
That's great. Good. And I played on Friday at a place called 211 Main, which is tons of fun. It was great. Place was jumping in. People were awesome. It was really, really nice. I had a great time. If you're looking for something to do this week, we got a couple of things coming up. Tomorrow night, I'm back at the Thirsty Cactus.
That's right.
Which I do every Wednesday this month. usually it's every other Wednesday. But tomorrow is April 17th. I'm going to be playing from 7:30 until 10:30 solo. In the main room, the dining area of the Thirsty Cactus Cantina and Grill. And it's down right at the corner of Main and King in Dundas. They're awesome people. Come on down. It's very laid back and it's great. People there, they'll talk to you about anything. They're great.
Yeah, it's a super spot. They have great food there too. Oh my
really
God.
Do.
Just why do all the places we play at have such great food?
Yeah, what is with that? Do you want to talk about the gig that worked? Doing on Friday or
I think maybe we should play some music.
Okay, let's do that. We'll do that. We'll tell you about it in a sec.
Talk later.
It was a beautiful day, Barb. Yeah, good point.
It was lovely. The wind was a little chilly.
But it was gorgeous, yeah.
But the sun was shining. Indeed. And I did not wear a coat outside, and that is always a beautiful day. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Around naked in the living room. Thank you. And also, I'm guessing Mandy, which is my mom, you mean your mom, which is Sharon. And if so, hello.
Good timing. It's really good timing.
Is it?
Yes.
Oh, yes, it is. She's on Facebook. Why is she on Facebook? She shouldn't be on Facebook. She should be on YouTube.
Why?
Because YouTube's better. Honest to God. It's better for commenting and watching and communicating with all the people. I mean, I love you, Facebook, but really.
Actually, yeah, it's a good point. When you're on YouTube, you can see all the comments.
Yes.
When you're on Facebook, you only see
half
of them.
That's what I'm saying. So she should
But
be...
we still love that you guys watch us on Facebook.
Of
it's
course.
Awesome. You know, we appreciate
of course.
It. But if you want to get the full picture.
I really don't care where. But if you can't comment, maybe check on over YouTube.
Yeah. Never know.
Maybe. And maybe it will work. I don't know. Yeah. I don't know. Could be something weird.
While you're there, why don't you just throw more likes on the place?
Like us.
Just litter the place with likes. Just throw likes
everywhere. Like us
everywhere. Great song. You have to do that every week now.
Subscribe.
No song for that. That's okay. And why don't you go ahead and throw a tip? You can e-transfer to adamostrosser@gmail.com. It's a nice night out there. Yeah. Or you can use the tip link to send a secure tip
PayPal.me/adamostrosser.
Yeah, you're good at that. It's good. E-transfer again. That's the old graphic.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can do either or.
You can.
It all gets to the right location.
That isn't why it's good timing, Sharon.
The
good timing.
No, that's not what we were leading to at all, no. Grandma.
No, we were saying we very next on our list.
We're going to do a CCR tune.
There you go.
That's what he means.
That's what I mean.
Spit it out.
Do it. Tell you guys about something that's coming up on May 31st. Be prepared. Are tickets on sale yet?
May 1st, tickets will go on sale
tickets
for those who have not already purchased tickets.
So the letting go you know, Sarah released an album last year called Letting Go. The finale online show is going to happen on May 31st for people who already bought tickets. Your tickets are still good. If you haven't bought tickets, they're going to go on sale again May 1st. And you want to check it out. Here's a little promo video about that. Yeah, so make sure that you are a part of that. We'd love to see you there. It'd be awesome.
Yes, we would.
Be a part of the story. You know what I'm saying? So this is a tune by Eric Clapton.
What?
Eric Clapton.
What?
Eric Clapton.
Okay.
It's called Wonderful Tonight. Ready?
Yeah.
So that was an Eric Clapton tune that was called Wonderful Tonight. It's wonderful to have all you guys here tonight. Thanks very much for joining us. We're called Sarah and Adam.
Yes, we are.
And we do this, sorry about that, tuning in your ear. We do this every week, right here on Facebook Live and on YouTube. But if you'd like to come and see us play live, then why don't you go down the road to Brantford to an awesome little club called Xander's.
Where all roads meet.
What's that?
It's where all roads meet.
Where all roads meet, yes. Come for the food, stay for the experience. The
That's
experience.
Right, the experience.
The experience being live music.
Uh-huh.
Which is on Friday, April the 19th, Sarah and Adam. That's us. We're appearing live in person. It's actually 8:30 to 11.
Yeah, it's 8:30 to 11:30. Just in case you want to catch the beginning of the show, we start at 8:30. That is people permitting, because there's a lot of people there usually on Friday nights for supper. So if they're not out of our way, then we can't play until they get out of our way.
That's right. Yeah, they have tables on the stage.
They do. There, so. Yeah. But we should be starting at 8:30. Yes.
And that's great. I mean, it's awesome that they're doing so well.
If not, we start at 9.
We always have a great time playing there. We actually got other gigs out of playing there, which is awesome. So, I mean, it's a great little place to be.
It is a great little spot.
We now play in two places in Bradford.
Yeah.
Bradford. Isn't that cool?
It's awesome. Very cool.
Yeah. We got gigs coming up this year. We're going to be playing in Caledonia again quite a bit. We're going out to Port Rowan again. We'll be in Dundas. We're going to be in Bradford. This is an awesome year. We've got all kinds of cool stuff going on.
So far.
I'm going to be up north, which is great, playing in Severn Lodge. So it's going to be awesome. Sarah's going to be doing solos at the Pheasant Plucker and more stuff in Burlington. So it's going to be killer.
At Bear Field.
Yeah. So right arm. It's going to be a good time.
And the Coach and Lantern.
Oh, yeah. The Coach. That's going to be cool.
Yeah.
Good, good. I don't think there's anything else to announce this evening as far as plug-in stuff goes.
Okay.
So, let's do some Coldplay.
Okie doke.
Yeah. When I gave the word, now in the morning I sleep alone, sweep the streets I used to own. I used to roll the dice, feel the fear in my enemy's eyes. I'd listen as the crowd would sing, now the old king is dead, long live the king. I discover that my castle stands upon pillars of salt, pillars of sand. I hear Jerusalem bells are ringing, Roman cavalry choirs are singing. So be my man, my sword, my shield, my missionary in a foreign field. But for some reason I can't explain, once you go there, there was never, never. Shattered windows and the sound of drums. People couldn't believe what I'd become. Revolutionaries wait for my head on a silver plate. I'm just a puppet on a lonely string. Oh, who would ever wanna be king? I hear Jerusalem bells are ringing, Roman cavalry choirs are singing. So be my man, my son, my sheep.
Coldplay song. And we failed to mention that yesterday was somebody's birthday.
Oh.
Somebody that's watching the show. Just saying, he might be the last person to have made a comment from Facebook and is my father.
Oh, we should sing happy birthday.
My dad had a birthday yesterday and he turned 64. Right. 64. He was born in 1960.
When I get older, losing my hair, many years from now, will you still be sending me a Valentine? Birthday greetings, bottle of wine. If I've been out till 2:45, would you lock the door? Will you still need me? Will you still feed me when I'm 64?
Did you want to go on?
No, it's okay. That was good. No, that was fine. I always mix up. I always mix it up after that point.
Yeah, no problem. I thought that's what we do anyway, but...
Yeah,
so... Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
It's the first chord.
Happy birthday, dear father of mine.
And?
Happy birthday to
So we're going to do a, I think we're going to do a Johnny Cash song right now.
Okie dokie.
Yeah. That'd be good.
Johnny Cash it is.
Johnny Cash.
There's some Johnny Cash fans out there.
Fiery
Yeah, that was Johnny Cash.
Johnny Cashless Society.
I don't think so. Very much not. That's all I've seen lately.
Johnny debit card.
That's how people want to pay now, is cash, 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 cash.
Ironically, Johnny Cash being one of the first ATMs that there were out there, the Johnny Cash machine. Remember that?
No.
Yeah. Johnny Cash. And like he'd walk up in the commercial, hi, I'm Johnny Cash.
No
Johnny
way. Cash machine. Oh, yeah. My God. It was cheesy as hell.
Yeah. Yeah. Seriously, it happened.
Yeah. Actually, at this antique market that I'm doing, it's mostly cash. They have two cash machines there, and there's a lot of dealers that have been doing it for a long time, and that's just the way they do biz. Mm-hmm. But I do accept all other forms of payment, as well as cash. Either way, you gotta pay tax, because I have an HST account, so there you go. Just like every other business. Business.
Say that again.
Business.
There we go.
Business. Oh, God. Okay, we got one more song for you today, I think.
Two.
No, just one. Look at the time.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah. Do we need to recap, or do we just do a song? I think they heard enough of us talking tonight.
Yeah.
I think we talked more than our fair share of talking.
I think you're right. Well, I think we will end off with a lovely little song by Weezer.
Okay, fine.
So this is about having a holiday in the sun. I hope you guys have a great week.
Yes, I hope you do.
I'll see you on Tuesday. Yeah. Hip, hip. Hip, hip. So we'll see you next week. Thanks very much for supporting us tonight and for supporting our past shows. Do hit that like button right in the face.
Smash it.
Go ahead and subscribe. That'd be awesome too. And thanks for listening. We'll see you guys next week. Yay. Bye for now.
Bye.
Fell for you like a child.
Hey.